Hey guys, what's going on? It's Massive Dudes Weekly.
What? Now that's an intro. Only took us 10 times to get it right, but we finally got there.
Got it right the first time.
Welcome to Massive Joe's Weekly Word for the viewers at home, a new video series.
When you thought we couldn't get it.
When you thought that was we couldn't possibly release anymore, we're going to drop Massive Joe's Weekly Word.
So Joe just likes to make new segments so he can get more airtime.
It's not actually me, it's Adil. And this segment we've actually done to give you more airtime, Vanilla, because the viewers at home have demanded more Vanilla Gorilla. So this weekly word, Massive Joe's Weekly Word, man, it's a video segment based on a few things that have happened. Firstly, we did our TMJ in the USA, which was great for the Australian viewers. And then our US viewers said, hey man, you should do something similar when you get back to Australia.
So
like a day in the life of kind of stuff.
So
like
it's going to show you things that we do during the day.
It's going to show all kinds of stuff.
What we do on a daily basis.
We're going to answer questions.
Answer questions that have been coming in via email and through the FB.
That's it. That may not fit into any of our other video series, such as Exercise Encyclopedia, Raw Review, Sup Wars.
And also to stop us from talking shit at the end of every Sup Wars.
That's it. So this is just pretty much a segment for us to make contact with the viewers at home. Would you agree?
I would agree.
Do you concur?
I concur.
So this episode, the first episode of Massive Joe's Weekly Word, and actually, I must say as well, no surprises here, it's called Weekly Word because we plan on doing this bitch on a weekly basis.
I'd say bi-weekly.
I'd say weekly.
Tri-weekly.
Dude, I shoot so many videos, I don't have time to do more than one
maybe
a week.
Maybe Neve needs to make a cameo appearance.
Maybe Neve, well then we have to call it Neve's Weekly Word. Anyway, this episode we're going to talk about three things, man. First thing we're going to talk about is MTS in Australia. My man Mark Loebline, the supplement brand, we get hit up how many times a day? 5 to 10?
At least.
I'd say at least 5 to 10 times, at least 5, no more than 10 times a day about where MTS is, when's it going to be available, what products we're bringing in, how you can get them, how much they're going to be, etc., etc., etc. Second thing we're going to talk about, man, is we have been getting hit up now that the competition season is over in Australia for bodybuilding and fitness competitors. People have been hitting us up left, right, and center about sponsorship. So we thought we'd give the viewers at home a few tips on how to get yourself sponsored if you are a bodybuilder, a physique competitor, a fitness competitor, a bikini competitor, a figure competitor, just a competitor, how to get sponsored. And then finally,
about the old V-squat machine.
We're going to have a bit of a chat about V-squat machine. We shot some footage last night during our epic leg workout apiece. We're going to show you Team Massive Joe style to make the most of that V-squat machine that tends to f*** on everyone.
Back up. So we found a way to target. It's not really a new way, but it's just a better way.
It's a Team Massive Joe's way. It's a one-way ticket to Snap City, I ain't going to lie. But it's going to build your quads apiece, man. Let's get going, Neve. First thing, MTS in Australia. It's not a game.
Who's the distributors?
We are.
Exactly.
Massive Joe's. We're bringing it in, man. What products are we bringing in?
MTS Whey, having in my MTS Whey sludge.
Which is a whey protein supplement. Low carb, low fat. Not zero carb, zero fat, but low carb, low fat. Awesome product.
Chocolate vanilla.
We're bringing in a chocolate and vanilla.
Coming soon, cookies and cream.
Cookies and cream will be on the next shipment.
I'm going to talk Mark into Choc Mint.
Are you really?
Mark? Mate, chalk me up.
Second product we're bringing in on the same shipment as the MTS Whey is MTS Clash, which is Mark's pre-workout supplement. Awesome pre-workout supplement. Very basic, but correctly dosed, man. Mm. Clinically dosed and going to get you awesome muscle pumps, awesome mental clarity, and awesome energy in the gym with no crash. And that comes in one flavor, comes in lemonade at the moment. And then...
But it's an awesome tasting lemonade.
We're bringing in the yet to be released. We're going to have it first over here. It's called Machine Fuel. It's an intra-workout lean BCAA formula. It's coming in two flavors. Coming in grape
and
watermelon. I think those are the two, aren't it?
Yeah.
Grape and watermelon. That's coming as well, man. When's it going to be here, Neve?
It's on the water, so it's actually already on the ship.
It's actually on the ship, on the way to Australia.
So it'll be here within about 4 weeks.
We're expecting it
middle of December.
It'll be here before Christmas. It'll be an early Christmas present for the viewers at home. In terms of the pricing, We're still not 100% on the pricing, but I'm gonna give the viewers at home some approximate prices to brew on. NTS weighing the 5 pounds, which is gonna be 75 to 80 serves, you're talking between 90 and 100 bucks.
I'm going 90 bucks. All right, you heard it here first, 90
bucks. It's gonna be between 90 and 100.
Nia says 90.
NTS Clash, the pre-workout supplement. It's gonna be 30 serves.
Yes.
And you're gonna be talking 50 to 60 bucks.
I'm going more towards 60.
MTS Machine Fuel, the BCAA, comes in the 30 serves. In the grape and watermelon, we're talking somewhere between 40 and 50 bucks, man.
I don't know yet on that one.
Yeah, it's gonna be around there. So the prices are gonna be spectacular. You know that they're being produced by my man, Mark Loebliner, who used to own a company that we're not gonna mention because they're f***ing potatoes. I didn't mention them.
No lawsuits.
No lawsuits coming our way. Anyway, made by my man Mark Loebliner, and you know, Machine, it's not a game. They're coming, and you better be prepared, man.
And Mark, if they do send us an email, I'm hitting them back with a lol.
And the other thing we get asked about as well is the Machine training. The Machine training
that took
solutions.
You a while to get that one.
I know that was a late response. The Machine training solutions apparel, such as the one I'm wearing with the big M, man. We're going to get some of that on its way as well.
And so, the green one with the militia.
Hopefully, Mr. Loebliner can send us some of that as well, man. So we might even do some sort of promo. You know, buy a tub, get a free shirt. Or buy a stack, get a free shirt. Something like that. Moving right along, man. Second point of interest, how to get sponsored. Nee, I'm gonna let you lead off for the viewers at home in this one, man. Because we get hit up every day about people wanting sponsorship. What are the sort of things we look for when we're looking to sponsor athletes?
When we sponsor some of the best athletes in the country at the moment, aren't we, Joseph?
We do. We have world champions, man. We're very, very fortunate to have such high caliber athletes who want to represent Team Massive Joes.
My boy Jake Nikolopoulos?
We do. Is one of them. Asher Coulthard, our premier female sponsored athlete. Man, we got all kinds of, we're very fortunate with our sponsored athletes, but we get hit up about sponsorship. What do we look for when we're looking for athletes that we're looking to sponsor?
Personally, here at Massive Joes, we look for somebody who has won a state or national title in their chosen sport.
That's it. And not all companies, if you're looking to get sponsored, obviously the better you have done, the more titles you have won and the more prestigious titles you have won are gonna go a long way in getting you sponsorship with the bigger companies. Not all companies are as strict as us with that, but most of them want the best athletes. So the first thing they're gonna look for is a reputable state or national title in your chosen sport. That's the first thing. But nobody wants a high caliber athlete who's got their head stuck so far up their ass that it pops back out their neck, man.
And so another thing,
you gotta be humble. You have to be humble.
And also, I'm gonna put it out there, at least a following in the social media.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think today,
Massive Joes especially, here we are massive on Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. We got it covered.
Yeah, you have to, you know, from a company's point of view, they want top caliber athletes who are relatable, who they can market, who are humble because no one wants a prick, and who also have ways to facilitate that marketing, which means you have to have a big following on your chosen social networks, whether that be Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, whatever it is. The bigger your social networking following, the more likely a company is to see that as a positive because you've pretty much created a market that they can market their products into. So that's gonna be a big deal as well. Pretty much, if you've got those three things covered, man, if you're a top caliber athlete, you're humble, and you're very marketable and got those social networks in place, someone's gonna pick you up.
If you have those three qualities, hit us up at sales@massivejoes.com.
I was gonna say, and if you don't hit us up, not everyone's gonna hit us up, man. Not everyone likes us, let's be honest. But any company you're gonna hit up, don't shortchange yourself. If you tick all those boxes and you know what you're worth, don't let anyone throw you a t-shirt and a supplement bag and say, you're a sponsored athlete.
Oh, I bet.
Because we know there's a bunch of those around, man.
Here's your free t-shirt. Here's your, and here is your list of taste testings you have to go do this week.
That's it. And we're going to use you as a promo model. You know your worth. Talk to the supplement company that you're trying to get sponsored. Say, man, what are you going to use me for? What sort of income are you hoping to generate from me? And don't cut yourself short, man. Don't shortchange yourself. Make sure you get what you're worth. Agreed?
Agreed.
Anything else you want to add for those prospective sponsored athletes out there, man?
Don't give up.
Don't give up. And hit us up at Team Massive Joe's. If you tick all those boxes, man, we're always looking for top caliber athletes
and
who are humble and marketable.
And don't think we're complete dickheads.
Bob.
It's always a positive.
It's always a positive. Anyway, moving on to the last point of this MJ's Weekly Word. Man, we got some video footage. We're going to get Big Dilip, our media manager, splicing on this bitch. Adil, this is where you splice that footage in, my man. Drop it. So check this machine out, man. This is the typical, what you tend to see at any time fitness gyms. Yeah, Nee?
Hammer strength V-squat.
Hammer strength V-squat. One of the most retarded machines we have seen thus far.
I love it, though. No. I do love it.
I love it when we do it the way we do it, but the way you're supposed to use it is you're supposed to have your back up against that pad and you're supposed to sit down in there, and what it does is it rotates down but rotates backwards as well, so it kind of pushes your hips backwards against the plate. It's just a really, really awkward movement, and in particular for a V-squat, which is a modification of a hack squat, it hits way too much glute.
Yeah.
And we've always had a problem with it, man. So what we decided was, we decided, you know what, we're going to use the machine, we're going to flip up the way you use it, we're going to use this bit backwards.
So this is about, I'm going to set the scene for the people at home.
Go for it.
This is 5 plates aside.
It's heavy.
So it's heavy, so I've got my knee wraps on, and we're facing the other way.
Yeah, so we're facing backwards.
You can do this with your regular V-squat, like a V-squat as we're using here, or you can use it with a hack squat as well.
Yeah, but this in particular, because these V-squats, and in particular Anytime Fitness gyms, are popping up everywhere, you're more than likely to see one of these at some point. If you flip it up and you do it like this, you can see that side profile, it's pretty much like a front squat.
Yeah.
So it puts a lot of pressure on those quads, like hack squat is supposed to.
You definitely feel it through your glutes and your quads.
Yeah, but it takes a lot of pressure off the glutes as well. Don't get me wrong, it's by far a one-way ticket to Snap City, so don't snap your shit up. But if you want to use this machine, you want to use it properly, man, that's the best way to use it.
So that's it, guys. That's our first edition of Massive Joe's Weekly.
What?
Works well.
We've been working on that intro so much. It's an intro and an outro. So that's it, man. That's the first episode. We hope you guys enjoyed it. You know what? If there's anything that you want us to talk about, is anything you want to see, and I know in particular, the US viewers at home want to see some stuff. They want to see my pet kangaroo that the Hodge friends are talking about. Man, you want to see anything that you don't necessarily get to see in the US that we can drop in on this bitch, man? Write it as a comment to this video.
Or, we'll make it happen. Or whatever you want to see. Whatever you want to see in a daily life.
We're happy to present it. We're opening up our lives
of Neve and the hose.
Kind of. Keep the private stuff private, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Guys, hit the subscribe button. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, man. Stay up to date with all the weekly editions of Massive Joe's Weekly Word and all the other deliciousness we've got going on YouTube. And guys, that is Massive Joe's Weekly Word. And I'm coming to you from
MassiveJoes.com.